Hi everyone, haven't done a classic tutorial in a minute. And since I missed it, I thought why not start 2023 by celebrating the Chinese New Year, aka the Year of the Rabbit. Here's what I came up with, and here's how I did it. We are basing our design on this sketch, which you can download from the description below. And we're starting off with the patterns, because then all you need to do is duplicate all these elements to add as much depth to your design as you want. So for the background, we are using this bright red for the fill, while the stroke is a deep red. We're creating one circle, like so, but we are going to adjust the shape so it's flatter in the middle. Now I'm adjusting the opacity so I can see the pattern that I need to create. We are going to duplicate it and make it smaller. Duplicate again and make it smaller. And so on, until we have all the arches we need. This is what we have until now. Next, we're going to group it together and duplicate it a few times. Once we have a full row, it's easier to just group these objects and then duplicate them all together. Make sure you offset the second row, so they are not stacked on top of each other on the same line. Once we have these two rows together, we can group and copy and paste once again. And one cool trick here is using the duplicate and transform function. This ensures that the rows will be evenly spaced out from each other. Nice! Later we'll place this under a mask layer. But for now, let's save it to our templates. And focus on another element of our pattern, the cherry blossoms. We're sticking with the deep red and the oval tool. Let's create one circle. Then activate rotate and duplicate at the same time. You need to make sure that the pivot point is in the middle of the flower. And then simply drag and drop. Let's reduce the opacity once again so we can focus on the pattern underneath. Here we're going to draw the two circles and the line. And use Unite to create one single shape. Then just do what we did before. Rotate and duplicate. In this case, we can hold down one finger, which snaps the rotation every 45 degrees. And that's that. Now we just need to group, scale down, and rotate so we get the little filaments in between. In hindsight, I could have used duplicate and scale as a dual function. But anyway. One last detail here. I want all the decorations on the flower to be negative space. So I will use boolean subtract. Notice how this operation just punched the entire cluster of elements out. Now this is one seamless shape, so I'm going to add it to templates too. Alright, the next pattern element is the cloud. And I'm choosing this beautiful golden looking gradient to create it. With the pen tool, I'm just tapping and dragging in the direction of the path. Where I have a pointed tip, I just tap without dragging. And where I have a crazy shape like this, I hold down one finger to bring one handle to the opposite side. We have a lot of tutorials on the pen tool, including a dedicated episode in our 101 course. However neat or messy your lines are, it doesn't matter, because we have the node tool to clean up any curves. Use it to move nodes around or adjust their handles. I'm happy with my shape now, so let's add it to templates as well. The last little elements we're creating, we're drawing this other type of flower here on the rabbit's body. First, we're making an oval. And using the node tool, we're just tapping on the top and bottom anchor points. As we did with the cherry blossom, we're duplicating, scaling, and subtracting the smaller shape from the bigger one. Once that is done, we're going to rotate and duplicate while holding down one finger. These elemental shapes are a great exercise to learn the basics of our selection tool modes. With all these simple patterns under our belt, it's time to focus on our main character, the rabbit. And we're creating it in a way that might surprise you. But bear with me. With the pen tool, I'm tracing the outer circle and the rabbit shapes together using the gold gradient. Then we are switching colors. And we are tracing the space here where the background should be. So in between the rabbit and the inner circle. Some areas are super easy, like this one, while some areas a bit trickier. Like for example here. We need to trace the line that defines the hind leg of the rabbit too. And don't forget about the front legs either. So let's manipulate this with the knot tool. Step 1, we're bringing this one knot here. Step 2, we're adding an extra node and pulling it down. The rest just comes from handle adjustments. Next up, we're adding all these details to the rabbit's body. Like the ears, the eye, these little teardrops. And all the flowers we made earlier. Time for the big reveal. We're going to select everything we just created and subtract it from the original golden rabbit shape. To give it a paper cutout effect, I'm also adding a shadow. You can move the angle however you want, but 250 works for me. By now, you probably guessed that we're going to add the wavy pattern we created at the beginning in the negative space of the decal. So, add it with one tap. The easiest thing here is to create another circle and place it under the pattern. If your rabbit layer is locked, all you need to do now is select everything and tap on mask. And with that, all the hard work is done. Now we just need to add the clouds and the details. I have alternated between red and golden, but I've also added a shadow for each element so it stands out more. And I've also given the same direction to all my gradients so they look seamless. Finally, let's wish everyone a happy new year. Start off with creating a circle that follows the curvature of the text. My font of choice is copper plate regular in 38. Then with the text tool, we're just writing our feel-good message. Alright, now select both the text and the circle and scroll down until you find Place Text on Path. The nice thing is that you can rotate the text just like any other shape. This was the last detail, guys. We're done. It's always these simple designs that take longer than anticipated, isn't it? But it's so worth it in the end. Happy Year of the Rabbit, everyone. I will see you in my next video. In the meantime, don't forget to check out the one-on-one course for an in-depth look at all these techniques.